Hi everybody. I decided to do a pre-recorded video in regards to some compliance. So when we all join Scentsy, half the time, now I'm guilty of this as well. When I first joined, I was so excited I didn't even read that compliance guide from front to back. I kind of skimmed it, kind of got an idea of what, right? But in reality, our compliance guide is one of the most important things when it comes to our business. Every business has their rules, right? Their compliance, their policies, do's and don'ts. Scentsy is the same way. We've got policies and compliance rules in place to not only protect us as an independent Scentsy consultant, but it also protects Scentsy, okay? I have pulled up the compliance chapter book only because I want to make sure I'm not leading you guys down the wrong way. I know the grasp of the compliance policies and what not to do and what to do, but I want to make sure I get my terms and all that kind of specs out there. So first and foremost, let me just throw out some basics. So when you're posting in your Scentsy business, whether it's your Scentsy business page or business group, or even in your personal page, any social media for that matter, or even on flyers, anything that you're posting out to the public, okay, whether it's social media or in person, I'm sorry, not in person, but on paper, public. People can see it. Anybody can see it. It's not private. Everything has to be compliant, meaning that you cannot post your specials. You can't post your, if you're selling a bundle for 30 and it is $50 in product, then you are discounting the product and you're publicly letting people know that you're selling this basket for 30 and it's over $50 in retail. You're not allowed to do that. You only are allowed to post what Scentsy advertises on their site. So if the bundle is 30, you need to sell it for 30 publicly. Whatever you do in your PMs is on you. Okay. So for instance, the specials that you want to do, the giveaways, the special pricings, the bundling, all of that nook and cranny stuff, do it via PM. Do not post that publicly or on paper and post it in the library, things like that. Publicly, you cannot do that. As far as specials, let me just reiterate that as well, is that you cannot make flyers that indicate anything. Like if you're having a special, if you're giving away shipping, if you're, buy one, get one free, any special that you want to do, especially for the holidays with the Black Friday sales. And the Cyber Monday ideas, you cannot disclose what you're doing. All you can basically say is make a flyer or create a post and say, who wants to know about my Black Friday specials? Who wants to know about my Cyber Monday specials? You don't want to miss out. You do cannot disclose what you're actually giving away, what your special is. So if your special is, buy two scent bars, get two free, whatever the case may be, it is your special. You can do whatever you want. Keep in mind, we are here as a family-owned business to where you are making money for you, your family, whatever the case may be. Don't break the bank to create these humongous specials and you're not making money at the end of the day. You're actually digging into your family money, maybe, or even Scentsy money. That's up to you. But don't break the bank. Okay, maybe a free scent circle, maybe a free sample pack, maybe, little trinkets here and there that you've collected along the way from the dollar store or from Target, dollar bin. Do not feel like you have to break the bank, give away the cow and the milk to these customers because we are here at the end of the day to make money, to change our lives one way or another, right? As Orville always says, do not spend family money on Scentsy. Okay, so when you get your Scentsy paycheck every month, you determine your budget. Is it $100 back into your business? Is it $20 back into your business? Is it $200 back into your business? You determine your budget. My budget may be different than your budget. I've been doing this now for 5.5 years. My budget may be way different than someone that is just starting out and their paychecks are smaller. You see what I'm saying? So you determine your budget. Your budget can change over time. It doesn't have to set in stone. But make sure, I wanted to throw that out there. You do not absolutely have to do specials for Black Friday. And you're going to be seeing that across the board in Scentsy World. People are going to be offering these Black Friday specials, Cyber Monday specials, Thanksgiving specials. You probably have seen me do specials along the way if you've been with me for a bit. But I do not offer the cow and the milk. I offer small things. I offer a scent circle with every purchase today, or I offer sample packs, or I offer a happy mail for the first five customers that place a $100 order, whatever the case may be. So that's a lot in a nutshell as far as specials. Do not publicly post them on your social medias, whatever the case may be, wherever you post. Everything has to be PM'd. All your specials, all of that has to be PM'd. You cannot do giveaways and tell people what you're giving away in your posts. It is just a strictly, I am doing a giveaway, y'all. You cannot entice people to want to order as well. You know, so you can't say the next, you know, anyone that orders today, not orders today. You can't do raffling tickets. Like if you are saying, you know, the first 10 people that order, you get a drawing entry, you know, for this basket of stuff. And you cannot do any type of gambling, like play to pay to play. Like you can't do drawing entries to where, you know, people buy tickets. And they get their name on a list, and then whoever wins, they get all the Scentsy. That's not how that works. So they cannot buy tickets into whatever you're doing. So certain behaviors and actions are strictly prohibited, and they're never acceptable. Now, mind you, we are humans. We are not perfect. There may be times that a slip up here or there may happen. It's happened to me. I've learned my lesson. I keep it moving. Do not become a repeat offender, however. So you will get notified as well as your upline when something happens and they feel it's been your the compliance policies have been abused. Now, mind you, they're not out there to get you guys, right? So if you're out there and you're innocently, you didn't realize that that was a post you shouldn't have posted, you take it down immediately, you move on, okay? But if you are habitual, you keep doing it often, okay? Eventually, your account will be shut down and you can no longer be a consultant. I don't know the nuts and berries to that as far as like, well, are you allowed to come back and how long you have to wait until you come back? I need to read up on that myself, but I don't know what the options are there, but just don't get yourself in that situation. You won't have to worry about it, right? You cannot bonus buy, okay? So if your upline is $50 away from promoting, right? You cannot buy their stuff and place an order to them so that they can promote or they can hit an incentive or they can whatever, okay? You're not allowed to do that. Just encourage your team members to hit their goals, help them out, offer challenges. You know, you can post in their group, you can post on their social media, shout them out, get them riled up, get their customers and their friends riled up, and then that will help them reach their goals if they're that close. Do not bonus buy. Do not get into that predicament where you are buying product off of your downlines or uplines websites to get them to promote. That is totally not allowed. Don't get yourself into that situation. You cannot sell Scentsy products in a retail location. So like people have asked me, you should put a little shop up at the mall, or you should put a little shop up. You're not allowed to do that. It's against policy, it's against compliance. You can post in a temporary location. So, for instance, yard sales, vendor events, the fairground, if it's temporary, like things like that. And it's one consultant. Okay. So, there's not a competition where there's like five of you guys at the same event. Sometimes that does happen, not five, but maybe one or two extra. But typically, the event coordinator only allows, and it should be allowing, only one Scentsy consultant per event. And you can do things like that. You can do temporary postings where you're popping up a table, and the same rules apply. You cannot publicly, you know, give away stuff or announce your specials or anything because you're in a public setting. That's only done throughout the your social media private message. You cannot sell or post products on eBay, Amazon, Mercari, Facebook Marketplace, things that are recognized as an e-commerce platform. You're not allowed to do that. You're not. You're not allowed to sell your products and mark them off or whatever price may be. You can't mark them up. You can't mark them down. As long as you're a Scentsy consultant, you're not allowed to do that. You can, however, publicize a special that Scentsy's offering, or you can publicize products that Scentsy has on their website. You can publicize that public stuff and let people know this is what's going on with Scentsy. Here's my website. You can do that. If you're trying to promote, I'm not trying to promote, but if you're trying to grow your team and there's a join special, you can post a flyer from the workstation, or if there's other flyers that have been created by other consulting groups, you can post that and post your join link. You can do things like that, but you cannot post your stock, if you have stock, as a consultant. Just can't do it. It's against against the compliance guide. And I'm going along the compliance guide. I'm trying to keep this short and sweet, but if you type compliance guide at the top of your search bar in the Scentsy Success tab, you will find what I'm reading off of. There's many chapters. Each one is explained, but I'm just kind of give you an overview of stuff. You cannot, as far as marketing, and there's so much to this, I'm not even going to really go too far into detail. But like marketing, you got to make sure the logo is in the right guidelines. You got to make sure that, you know, you cannot alter the logo. You cannot put your logo, put Scentsy's logo on another licensed company's logo. Like, there's just some ins and outs of that. Make sure you're looking at the marketing ways of all that as far as compliance. As far as licensing, you cannot create flyers with our licensed products. So you guys know we have contracts with other companies, Disney, DC Comics, Warner Brothers, all that, right? You're not allowed to use those products and make your own flyers. It's just an if and no but about it. It's part of the contract between Scentsy and that company. And we are not allowed to create custom flyers with licensed products. And if you do save images straight from the workstation or straight from your website, you can do that and post them by themselves, yes, but you're not allowed, let's just say for instance, you put them into your social media, your wherever, you cannot put wording on top of those pictures, you cannot put any emojis on top of those pictures, you cannot draw on top of those pictures and save them and put them on your Instagram or anything, stories, you got to make sure that they're individually pictured, there's cannot be any writing, any changes to that picture. It is strictly just the item of that licensed product, okay? I see a lot of people making flyers with these licensed products, and that's a big no-no. That's part of our contract, and that could risk Scentsy losing the contract if they start seeing that stuff happening in public. So make sure you're not making any licensed flyers. Use what's in the workstation. Scentsy provides many, many marketing flyers and pictures and all of that jazz. Use what Scentsy provides us, okay? That is it. You will not see nobody creating flyers in those consultant flyer groups, and do not make them yourself, okay? Big, big, big no-no. I just want to throw that out there. I have seen it here and there. And do not write on it, none of that. First and foremost, you are an independent Scentsy consultant, but we are on behalf of Scentsy. So act accordingly. Do not claim something that Scentsy does and they do not, because that's a big no-no, of course. You know, it's just common sense, y'all. You know, you're an independent Scentsy consultant. Yes, we are business owners, but at the end of the day, we are representing Scentsy. If Scentsy doesn't offer it, or Scentsy doesn't do A, B, C, and D, then you are not to tell the public that Scentsy does A, B, C, and D, because you're claiming something against Scentsy that they don't do. Now, mind you, personal specials are personal specials. If you want to offer stuff at a discount or give away stuff or free shipping or whatever, that has got to be done via PM, okay? It is advised that we are not to claim we have inventory on hand. Scentsy actually despises us doesn't want us to have inventory on hand. Our focus is to sell from the site and not go into debt. Like Scentsy encourages us to not buy and let it sit on our shelves, and we've become in debt because of it. And it's happened. They don't require any inventory. And like I said, they actually prohibit you from building up excessive amounts of inventory, which is also considered inventory loading. They suggest that if you do have inventory on your hands, please advertise it in these simple rules. You may offer it as cash and carry, like I mentioned, at like an open house, a yard sale, things like that. But you cannot share any details of images that you have on hand, and you may not share any details. You can accept private 101. Yeah, so you cannot offer this inventory on your website. So if you have, your social media. So if you have inventory, you're not allowed to post it publicly and say, I've got A, B, C, and D. Who wants them? They're $5 each. Or A, B, C, you know, even if you don't put pricing out there, you are not allowed to post a picture of all your inventory or shelves of inventory or boxes of inventory and tell people that you got inventory or you've got it on hand. Let them know if you need anything. You're not allowed to do that. Like I mentioned, you're not allowed to sell on permanent basis locations. So like malls, stores, things that are permanent, you're not allowed. And I think I've talked about, and then that mentions pictures and videos of advertisements. And we talked about where you're not allowed to advertise, you know, as far as the marketplace, Amazon, eBay, all of that good stuff. And as far as like paying to pay and other on all that stuff, we talked kind of skimmed over them. Like I said, I don't want to go on and on and on about this video. I'm on to almost 17 minutes worth, but I just kind of want to skim to you, especially about this personal specials, especially about pay to play. You're not allowed to have gambling, having them pay for tickets. You're not allowed to talk about your inventory if you have some and how to approach that. You are allowed to sell to other consultants. Like if another consultant is looking for something, you need to handle that transaction via PM, not in the post. And you've got to figure out the rate of that. So mind you, you cannot sell a Scentsy Buddy for $30 to a consultant. You've got to mark it down minus your commission. Because mind you, you are paying $30 for that Scentsy Buddy today, but you're going to get paid 25% commission next month, right? So you cannot expect not only you're going to get $30 full, but then you're going to get that 25% on top of that, you know, the following month. So consultant sales, you've got to minus your commission off of that product because you've been paid commission off of that product, or you're getting ready to be paid that commission. And then you are to then charge shipping tax. Or if they're porch pickup, then it's just tax on, you know, where you're selling from. So you have got to make sure you're doing that. A lot of people don't realize that you can't do that. So I'm just going back through. Just make sure, guys, like I said, there is so many other things. I don't want to, like, you know, keep going on and on and on and on about this. But that's pretty much it in a nutshell. Make sure you know your stuff. Make sure before you post something that it's correct. Make sure you're not making flyers of our licensed products. That's a big no-no. And then also when you're doing bundles or when you're doing mystery bags, if you're doing them in your business, let's say you got a bundle of $20 worth of Scentsy product, but then you've also added a few other things that maybe it's $20 worth of Scentsy product, but maybe at the end of the day it's $25 worth of stuff because you've added those little extras. You're not allowed to sell the bundle for more than the Scentsy product. So if that bundle is $20 in Scentsy product and you've added $5 of your own little goodies, guess what? You only are allowed to sell it at $20. You're not allowed to upsell your bundles because you want to charge them for the extra fluff. Okay? I've done a training before about cutting the fluff. If you cannot afford the fluff, sell the bundle and add just a couple of samples, a couple of Scentsy products if you sampled. That's it. You do not have to add all the extra fluff. You're not allowed to upsell your bundles, whether it's via PM or whether it's publicly. If you're doing it via PM, you're allowed to do it. But personally, at the end of the day, we are here to service our customers. If you're upselling your bundles just to give back all that money that you've done spent into the bundle, then what's the purpose of doing that? My way of doing them is that whenever I'm putting a party in, I'm always using my rewards to make things from them, or I'm able to gift extra items in my bundle. So for instance, if the Scentsy product is 20 in my bundle, I may add a free scent circle on top of that, or I may add a free car bar or whatever. I don't upsell my products. I don't. That's just something that I love to do. That's our customer service. You know, you're giving back. It's going to come back to you tenfold, as I always tell my team. But make sure you are not upselling these bundles, y'all. If that product is a Scentsy product is $22 or $25, then that is what you sell that bundle for. All the extra frillies should be part of your budget that you set every month for your Scentsy business. Do not spend family money on Scentsy money. On family money on Scentsy. Okay? If you can afford so and your budget allows it and you've set it out to be that way, then yes. I typically try to spend within $5 extra. So if that product bundle is 20, I'm usually putting within $5 or less in extras. Whether it's samples, whether it's a free scent circle, whether it's some knickknacks from, you know, little trinkets from the dollar bin at Target, or I love a family dollar or Dollar Tree or whatever. Sometimes you can get two for a dollar in some things. So make sure you're not breaking the bank when you're coming out to these bundles, but also keep in mind, do not advertise for more, and make sure you stay within your budget. So that's just kind of the compliance in a nutshell. Like I mentioned, in your Scentsy Success tab in your workstation at the top of the page, you type in compliance. There's so many things in there that are compliance related. You can read the whole manual from left to right, pretty much everything I've said in a nutshell. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.